मॉर्निंग सर। हाँ Very good morning, everyone, and we welcome you all to today's interactive video conference on role of intellectual property in innovation management, challenges and prospects, being organized in association with Ministry of MSME and PCTE Group of Institutes, Haryana. We have eminent speakers with us today for the session. So before we initiate our session, I request Dr. J.K. Sharma, he is the co-chairman Punjab Education Committee and Chief Operating Officer, Technology Business Incubation Foundation, IIT Roper, to formally initiate the session. I request him for his welcome address and also to moderate the session thereafter. Thank you, sir.
Thank you, Ramneet ma'am. I am audible.
Yes, sir.
Okay. Okay. So, a very good morning to all of you. On behalf of PIG Chamber of Commerce and on my own, I welcome all the participants and my friend, Professor Nadesh Sadeva from PCT Group of Badoval. They are very aggressively developing the entrepreneurship ecosystem in the region and particularly in their area. We have a strategic MOU with them also. We have very eminent speakers in today's session. And I will be failed in my duty if I will not recognizing the PhD chamber for their aggressive approach towards the sessions, either it is online, offline, on IPR, and patenting. I think this will be my fourth or fifth session, which I will be attending, and third, which will be as a moderator. And I'm happy that PSG has taken its niche to start it with the Association of PSG Chamber. PSG Chamber is very aggressively organizing the events, particularly on the IPR, and particularly their one event आज रविवार रवनी क्या नाम है उनका एग्जैक्टली
आईपीआर गुरुवार
आईपीआर गुरुवार
एवरी थर्सडे एवरी मंथ
एवरी थर्सडे एवरी
एवरी मंथ
एवरी थर्सडे एवरी मंथ
मतलब गुरुवार आईपीआर दिस इज बीइंग ऑर्गेनाइज्ड एवरी थर्सडे एवरी मंथ सो
आईपीआर
फॉर एनी क्वेरी
अगर आप ये देखिए तो ये जो कॉन्सेप्ट है बड़ा अच्छा है और जो इसकी बेसलाइन है वो बड़ी टचिंग है एंड मैं उस कमेटी में भी हूँ एंड पर्टिकुलरली जो आईपीआर फैसिलिटेशन सेंटर है वो बहुत अच्छा काम जो है वो कर रहा है सो वंस अगेन आई कॉन्ग्रेचुलेट पीएचडी चैम्बर एंड प्रोफेसर नरेश देव एंड एंटायर मैनेजमेंट ऑफ पीएचडी पीसीटी ग्रुप ऑफ दुवाल सो वी हैव एमिनेंट स्पीकर्स टुडे प्रोफेसर नरेश सदेव ही इज डीन कॉर्पोरेट रिलेशन पीसीटी ग्रुप ऑफ इंस्टीट्यूट्स लुधियाना आई वेलकम यू प्रोफेसर सदेवा We have Professor Satyajit Thin. He is Professor International Business, PTE Group of Institute. I also welcome Professor Thin. We have Dr. Shweta Sen. She is Head IPR Integrum IP Mohali. And I also welcome Advocate Geeta Gulati Ji. She is expert on trademarks and patent attorney based at Panchkula. Apart from our eminent speakers, I also welcome the faculty members and startups from PCT Group of Institute, students, industry partners, those who are attending today's session. So without taking time, as per the schedule, I will request Professor Deva for his address.
Thank you very much, Dr. Sharma. In fact, it's my privilege to be welcomed by you. I really feel privileged. And on behalf of my PCT Group of Institute, my all faculties, my all students, I express my gratitude towards the PhD Chamber, Madam Ramneet Kaur, Sumit Kumar sir, and all the dignitaries who are being there on the board for PhD Chamber for giving us this opportunity to hold such a intellectual seminar on intellectual property rights. And to my students, I would just like to reiterate that Professor Dr. Sharma is the one who is the pioneer and who is the one who has facilitated PCT as we have signed an MOU with him. And he belongs to one of the most finest of the college in case of, you say, engineering, that is IIT Roper. And he's the CEO of TBIF, the business incubator of IIT Roper. And as a parent institute, we have joined them as a child. So we get all the help from J.K. Sharma, sir. And to my students, I would like to tell, and to Dr. Sain also, and Advocate Geeta Gulati also, that PCT is sensitizing and fostering entrepreneurship the last 3.5 years, 4 years, very aggressively. We have a couple of startups which are also on board. We have one startup which is being selected into the Smart India Hackathon 2020 as one of the co-joint winner with the Ministry of Urban Housing. We have one startup which has now got incubated into TBIF, and that's thankful to J.K. Sharma, sir. All my gratitude to him. He selected that startup and he's now being incubated and got a grant of 4.5 lakhs in which they have started incepting their company, and henceforth they're going to roll their product and their innovative idea which they have. And also I would like to tell you that one of our startups, which is being named as Testum King, is again being accoladed by Ministry of Agriculture and Farmer Welfare. They were incubated and selected under Punjab Agri Business Incubator, and henceforth they got a grant for 15 lakh rupees. So all that I can say, my lovely students and my faculty across, and Dr. Thain and Satyajit Thain sir, and all my faculties are really aggressive, working very hard to sensitize and foster entrepreneurship and the PCT Group of Institute. And to my students, I would like to introduce both the panelists who are well-versed and have impeccable knowledge and wisdom as regards to IPR. My humble request to all my students, kindly put on their videos so that we can interact very nicely with the eminent speaker. As per Dr. Shweta Sain is an Indian patent agent with elaborate experience in patent and trademark filing system. And she also believes and she deals with the strategies and the patent laws. She possesses a doctorate degree in biotechnology and postgraduate diploma in intellectual property laws. Currently, she is working as a head intellectual property rights Intogram IP Mohali. And Dr. Shweta is the founder and CEO of Enoble, a woman innovation and entrepreneurship foundation, so-called as Cheryl. And she has a rich and affluent experience of corporate and educational expertise with excellence in the field of IPR and startup ecosystem. It's my privilege. I'm really thankful and I express my gratitude towards Dr. Shweta Sain to be one of the speakers for today. And I also take privilege to introduce to you Advocate Geeta Gulati. Madam Gulati is an advocate and intellectual property rights consultant. She practices in corporate and commercial litigation, both in domestic and international arbitration. And she specializes in corporate and commercial laws, which includes company law, business contracts, inward and outbound investment, joint ventures, securities, regulations, takeover of listed companies, direct and indirect taxes, merger and acquisition, and henceforth, a lot of list and to take on for both the panelists and both the speakers, Dr. Shweta Sain and Advocate Geeta Gulati. Once again, I express my gratitude, full heart welcome, namaskar, and a very good morning to each one of you present on the board And once again, heartily thanks to Madam Ramneet Kaur, PhD Chamber, and Professor Dr. Sharma to be here to enlighten us with such a good seminar. I'm really thankful, really thankful.
Thank you, Professor Deva, for your words. And I also welcome Advocate Geeta Gulati ji and Dr. Shweta Sen. I think we are meeting, thanks to Ramneet, we are connecting, I think, third or fourth time in the last 1 month. And मैम गुलाटी जो है उनकी तो कुछ जो टर्म्स हैं वो मुझे अभी जवानी याद हो गई हैं, क्योंकि वो जब ये बोलती हैं आंसर करती हैं तो मैं उसको साथ साथ रिपीट कर सकता हूँ. सो थैंक यू मैम फॉर जॉइनिंग अस. एंड एज रिक्वेस्टेड बाय प्रोफेसर देवा, आई विल रिक्वेस्ट द स्टूडेंट्स टू काइंडली स्विच ऑन देयर कैमराज एंड सो दैट वी कैन सी द ब्यूटिफुल फेसेस. And if recently now parde ke piche chupna ya camera ke piche chupna wo bahut zyada der nahi rahega. Agar aap logon ne pichle 10-12 din ki newspaper padhi ho to hamare ek research group ne ek software jo hai wo ijad kar diya hai, jisse wo chahe wo Google ke sath, Google Meet ke sath aap connect kar le, chahe wo Zoom ke sath aap connect kar le, to humko virtually pata chal jayega ki camera ke piche वाकई पार्टिसिपेंट है या वो पीछे किचन में जो है वो अपना किचन में काम चल रहा है. सो आई विल रिक्वेस्ट ऑल द पार्टिसिपेंट्स टू स्विच ऑन देयर कैमरास. एंड सो इसके पीछे एक पर्पस ये भी होता है कि हम लोग ज्यादा इंटरेक्टिवली जो है इंटरेक्टिव वे में जो है उनके साथ इंटरेक्ट कर सकें. Now, today's session is on a very genuine issue, and that is on IPR. And though it was always a very important issue, but particularly during the pandemic, jo iski aggressiveness hai ya jo iski hai wo aur zyada ho gayi hai, kyunki bahut sari jo innovations hain wo during pandemic jo hain wo hui hain. Aur har innovator aur har inventor jo hai wo chahta hai कि उसकी जो आईपी है वो उसके नाम पे या उसके इंस्टीट्यूशन के नाम पे जो है वो रिजर्व हो और वो सेफ हो और वो प्रोटेक्टेड हो. एंड इन इंडिया इफ आई विल नॉट रॉन्ग देन जो आइडियाज हैं आपके जो आईपी है वो आपकी बहुत जल्दी स्टील होती है. एंड उसको कैसे अच्छे तरीके से प्रोटेक्ट करना है, उसको कैसे अच्छे तरीके से डॉक्यूमेंटाइज करना है, कैसे उसको फाइल करना है, ये हमारे आज जो हमारे एक्सपर्ट्स हैं वो हमको बुलाएंगे. सो विदाउट टेकिंग फर्दर टाइम आई विल रिक्वेस्ट मैम गीता गुलाटी जी फॉर हर प्रेजेंटेशन ऑन ओवरव्यू ऑफ इंटेलेक्चुअल प्रॉपर्टी लॉज. सो दो प्रोफेसर देवा हैज ऑलरेडी इंट्रोड्यूस एडवोकेट गुलाटी, सो आई थिंक वी शुड नॉट विद मच टाइम एंड स्टेट वे रिक्वेस्ट मैम गुलाटी फॉर हिज प्रेजेंटेशन. मैम गुलाटी.
गुड मॉर्निंग. गुड मॉर्निंग एवरीबॉडी. गुड मॉर्निंग. गुड मॉर्निंग मैम. Good morning. Sir, I'd like to congratulate you and your institute. We read in the newspaper that your institute, in collaboration with Chima Boilers, you yes. have invented, there is a
mobile commission, mobile commission, ma'am.
Yes. So I think it's a brilliant idea, and like how an institute is collaborating with industry for such a thing, you know, which is a requirement of today. So it was great reading about it in the newspaper. And I think the reason why we are meeting today is like how each one of us can collaborate to innovate and, you know, so and help everybody. So that, you know, see why we need intellectual property. The reason we need is because of economic development. If there is no intellectual property, there is no innovation, how are we going to grow? If we look around on what are entrepreneurs doing, they are solving our problems. and how they are solving our problems by innovation, simple innovation. So there was a time, you know, you could not make calls. Today, because of mobile, the innovation, you are able to even talk. You can do video chat through your mobile. So how is this possible? Because of innovation. So that is the crux. Why we need this law? What was the requirement of having intellectual property? Is to secure the creativity of the innovator and for economic development of the nation and world. Now, with this background, I'll begin with types of intellectual property. Now, as Professor Sachdeva was sharing with us, the institute has few startups and they are encouraging entrepreneurship. Now, how does a startup safeguards its intellectual property? So, first and foremost, you need to know what is your business plan? What is it that you are bringing to market? Is it a service? Is it a good? And then you need to know and understand whether that goods or services has the potential of registering. A patent is something which is a new product which is not known to the humanity. Now it could be both the product or the process or both. So you need to see what is the innovation, whether it's completely a new product or it is an inventive step. Both the things can be patented. Now in India, we are unable to patent the software. There is a restriction that for software, it has to be embedded in a hardware. So say you develop an app, mobile app. Per se, mobile app cannot be registered as a patent. It has to be embedded in a hardware. Now, if this app is embedded in a mobile is a hardware, then it can be patented. So these are the things that you need to check before you start your business, whether your product is patentable or not. And then the question arises, when is the right time to file patent application? Now you don't have to wait for the time that, you know, your patent is, your product is ready for being manufactured in the factory. The moment you have an idea, you protect your idea. Now, how are you going to do it? You file an application. We call this application as provisional application. You file this application. You inform the patent office that this is what I plan to develop. And you will get a time of 1 year to file complete specification. And in this 1 year, you can develop your product. Now, very times we have seen that the organizations in 1 year are unable to complete their research. Then they come to us like, now what we do? There's no problem. There's no bar that you cannot refile your provisional application. In the first instance, if you're not able to do it, your application will lapse, but you can file the fresh application and again you can seek time. Now, once you file your complete specification with all the details that how you have reached to that product or a process or both, or the inventive step, your application will be examined by the patent office, and thereafter, if patent office feels that your product is inventive, patent will be granted to you. Now, how will this help you in your business? Now, just look around how businesses are developing because of innovation. Take example of Airtel. Airtel has the technology. Unless they have this technology, they cannot survive in the market. We are moving from 4G to 5G. So it's very important that they do research and development. So 5G is nothing but a new innovation. You have Hero Cycles in Ludhiana. Now, if you see how cycles have developed, any innovative step in the cycle could be patented. Now, how do you further do economic exploitation? Now, Shweta would be elaborating on that. but I'll just give you a gist of it. With your technology, you can either share it with other organizations, other countries, and when you are sharing it, you will be entering into different agreements. It could be a licensing agreement, it could be a technology transfer agreement, and on the basis of that, you can seek royalty or license fee from the other organization. Now, you would be curious to know the term of the patent. Once you file the patent, you've got the patent. Now, what is the term of the patent? So the term of the patent is 20 years, and thereafter you cannot renew it. And automatically after 20 years, this invention comes into public domain. Now let's take example of corona vaccines. There's so many vaccines in the market, but what is happening? The pharma companies who have developed these vaccines, they don't want to share their intellectual property with other pharma companies. The reason behind it is, I have spent lots of money doing research on this product. If I share it, then where is my profitability? Now, Pfizer today is not ready to share with any country. They say you buy on the price that I want to sell. The governments can buy. So, see, if you look at business, this is a good business. It makes good business sense. But then there is a concept in patent law which is called compulsory licensing. Compulsory licensing simply means that where it is for the welfare of general public, the invention can be shared with others. Therefore, we call it compulsory licensing. That compulsorily, you will have to give it to other organizations so that they can develop. Now, just last night, I was hearing that by December, we will be able to vaccinate some percentage of our population, which means that we need a lot of vaccination. Now, how can this be possible? It will only be possible if some local means Indian company is able to manufacture. Now, they will be able to manufacture if the companies who have already developed this vaccine, if they can give compulsory licensing to Indian companies, which is not happening at the moment. So, before I go further to some other intellectual property, I'd like to share a case study with you, which will help you understand like how this works in real world. Now, there was a case in Delhi High Court. Ericsson, a telecom company, had taken Xiaomi to court and also Micromax. Now, what they were alleging was, which they could prove also, that they have taken their technology, their standard essential patents. Now, what is standard essential patent? It's the technology patent. Now, they have copied that and they're using it for making their cell phones. Once they were able to prove it before the court granted them injunction. Injunction means that we understand that this is your innovation and no other company can manufacture the same product as yours or can copy your technology. So this is how it works. And not just this, the courts will also grant damages based on the infringement which the other companies have done. So now if they have copied the technology, they have made profit by selling that technology, accordingly, damages will be assessed and it will be given to the company whose technology was stolen. In this case, Ericsson. So this is how patents work. Now let's come to the second intellectual property. Now you have your idea, you're protected it by way of patents. But now you want to start your business, so you will want to name your business, because unless you name your business, how will consumer come to know about it? So what is this name? This name, your company name, your business name. In legal terms, this is trademark. So trademark is the name of your company and also the name of the product. Say under one company brand name, you have different products. Say, for example, Nestle. Nestle is a company, it has different products like Maggi. So they can register trademark of Nestle separately and trademark of Maggi, which is their product, separately. Now, what are covered under trademark? So trademark essentially covers the name of the company or the product, the color that you use, and the logo. Now, why is trademark important? Trademark is important because consumers will recognize the business from the name and the logo. Now, if you are on road, how do you recognize the type of cars which are on road? From the make of the car, and sometimes by looking at the logo. Once you look at the logo, if you see four circles, you know it's Audi. So if you look at triangle, you know it's Mercedes. So this is how, as a consumer, you will recognize trademarks. If you are shopping in a supermarket, how do you know that this is five-star chocolate? How do you know this is a shampoo of, some brand, say, you can take the example of Clinique, which is in the Sun Leavers. How do you recognize that this is the this is a talcum powder of Pond's or some other company? By the shape of the product, by the name of the product which is written on that shape of the product in which the product is, and by the trade dress. What is trade dress? Trade dress is the outer covering of the packet in which you will buy the product. See, when you're looking for Dabur products, it comes in a certain trade dress. When you're looking at a bottle of Ruabza, how do you recognize bottle of Ruabza from the trade dress and from the color of the bottle, the product which is inside the bottle? From a distance, you will recognize that this is Ruabza's product. Now, why is it so essential to protect trademark? If somebody tries to take your trademark, you have a goodwill in the market, they take it, they don't have any goodwill in the market, and from your goodwill, they start earning and making profit. That will impact you economically. Let me share one case law with you. Now, this happened just 2 days back. Goodyear, which is into manufacturing of tires, they came to know from market that there's some person who has registered, who is using the trademark as Goodyear to selling the products. Now, what was this person selling? This person was selling the brake oil, gear oil, which is in the same industry. When I say in the same industry, it means that tires are used in vehicles, so are gear oil and brake oil. Now, as a consumer, that you may get confused. You may get confused that this is the same company, Goodyear, who is manufacturing tires, and this is the same company who is manufacturing these oils. And you will buy it. Why you will buy? Because you know that Goodyear has a good goodwill in the market. You will trust this brand and you will buy it. Now, what happens when you buy? Actually, you're not paying to the same Goodyear company. You're actually paying to somebody who has taken the name and taking advantage of it. They were causing economic loss to Goodyear company, who has established their reputation and goodwill in Indian market from 1920, almost 100 years. So, to protect this, we have this law called trademark. Now, how do we go about protecting our trademark? The process of filing trademark is very simple, and even PhD has their own specialization center who will help you in filing your application. Applications are filed online. We always suggest our clients to do thorough search before they file their applications. In fact, I would say before you name your organization, before registering it as a company or partnership or any other business entity, you should initially check whether this name is available or not. Now, there's a reason behind it. Now, these days, businesses are online also. You would be taking your domain name also. A domain name is nothing but a trademark. It qualifies as a trademark. And if you are infringing someone else's trademark, like I gave you example of Goodyear. Now, this Goodyear, say they have this, they've taken a domain name, goodyear.in. Now, .in is a top-level domain name. Now, Goodyear, the company who is manufacturing tires, can actually go to the registering authority of company and say that you strike their name because they have infringed on my data. So you will lose the name in the company registry also. Therefore, it is important for you to do the thorough search and then you file your application. And there's another reason why we say, you know, do thorough search. Trademark registry will not give you registration if your mark is similar or it's same to be the already registered mark. For example, you know about Ruabza. Now, if somebody instead of Ruabza writes Muabza, they have changed one alphabet from R, it's M, but the trade dress is the same, so that you know any consumer will get confused. Now, trademark registry will never allow this mark to be registered because this is deceptively similar. Deceptively is that you are trying to deceive the consumers in believing that you are the original creator Ruabza. So there have been examples like somebody registered Majmola. Now, Majmola is very similar to Hajmola. You can't do that. So there have been very interesting examples where some person who was thinking themselves to be smart, they started using someone's already registered trademarks. But then registry will reject it. They will not grant it because they have a very good database. So our suggestion to you would be, do your complete search and then file your application. Once you have filed it, you will be granted trademark registration. This could be within few months. All you need to prove to the trademark registry is that you are actively using it and you are generating some revenue. Once you get it, it is valid for a period of 10 years and thereafter you can renew it any number of times. Now, what is the advantage of registering it? The advantage is that you become the legal owner and you can protect it and you can prevent other people from using the same thing. Now, there are things may be coming to your mind. First thing is, there are organizations who are operating in India. Apple is there. McDonald's is there, which is a very well-known mark. How are they operating? Registered in their parent country, and once they came to India, they again registered in India. That trademark is territorial. When I say territorial, is that you can register it in various geography wherever your business is. Automatically, you will not get it registered in all the countries. So ideally, you should register it only in those geographies where you have active business, where you have some sale of your product or services. Now, you must have seen that sometimes the owners write TM and sometimes they write R over their mark. So what is the difference between the two? When you TM, you're informing the general public, the world, that I have filed for this application. And it is pending registration. Once it is registered, you would see they start writing R. So in the well-known trademarks like Coca-Cola, on the right top side, you would see that they have written R. R in a circle, which means that this trademark is registered. Now, nobody can take this plea thereafter. You know, I didn't know about this, that this mark was registered. Like in this case of Goodyear. Goodyear got this order from Delhi High Court without listening to the other party, because court was convinced that the other parties, intentionally they have taken this mark. Now, this party will have to prove, which is going to be very difficult for them, that I didn't know that Goodyear was making tires. Why? Because, you know, it's all there in the news. The product is actively being used and sold in the Indian market. So you cannot say that you are not aware of it. So I've given you the reason why trademark is important. Trademark is important because then consumers will recognize your product or your services, and you can prevent others from copying your mark so that your goodwill is not used by any other entity. The way examples, so many examples. Now there's another thing what you must have. Delhi, you would see many Agarwal sweets. And in place like Chandigarh, you will see Chawla Chicken. So many of businesses are using this thing. Now what happens to these entities? Now, if you know they have been using this mark for many, many years, now today if they stop using it, it will cause them loss in the business. The consumers will not come to their shops. Now what, how can law protect it? The law says, all right, if you're using it for so many years, I'll allow everybody to use it, whosoever was using. So that, you know, you get legal ownership. That's how law comes and protects. But unless you have used it for many, many years, you cannot get the same name. Then there's another concept. Another concept is that say there was a mark, which is, we're just taking a hypothetical example, in, let's take Switzerland. And we all know that Rolex is a Swiss brand, very expensive brand. Now, say Rolex is not registered as a trademark in India. And you get a brilliant idea. Let me, you know, register my trademark as Rolex. Can you do it? The answer is no, you cannot. Reason is that Indian consumer is aware of Rolex marks. They know what Rolex is selling. So you will not be able to register this mark, even if this mark is not available, registered in India. But consumers, since consumers are aware, you will not get this. So this is all about trademarks. Now let's discuss about copyrights. What is the copyright? Now you see a lot of digital content these days. Now what is this digital content? You listen to music on FM. What is all this? This is an expression, a form of expression. So any form of expression can be copyright. It could be poetry, it could be in the form of some research paper. Now, how is this relevant for a business? The relevant is that when you start your business, you may have a brochure, you may have a research paper based on which you have developed a product, which is innovative product. You need to protect all these expressions. Why it is important for you to protect it? Now there are two threats. One, you will have from your employees who are working with you. You may have threat from your co-partners. They may take your intellectual property and leave you high and dry. And the third, you have it from your competitors. So how do you protect all this? You protect it by way of copyright. So before I go further, let me share one case with you that will make the concept clearer. Now, we listen to songs on FM while we are driving. Now, who are the original creator of this song? Now, they have their own means of sharing music. So they are earning from there. But FM is also earning. How is FM earning? By way of advertisement. But that is causing loss to the original creator. So how do you stop this? What these broadcasters need to do is, they need to enter into an agreement with the original creator and they have to share royalty with them. That's how they earn on their copyrights. So this is a new thing. It was not there in copyright. Very recently, this concept was added. That any broadcaster who is broadcasting or streaming live to other consumers and earning by way of advertisement, they will have to give share of that revenue to the original creator. Now, same thing happened during the FIFA World Cup also in 2014. It was the broadcaster was stopped from broadcasting to different channels. The reason was that it is their copyright. And how can one broadcaster earn revenue out of it, causing loss to the others? So then this concept of copyright was used. Now, as I told you initially, software cannot be patented. Now, if it is a software, how do you protect? You protect it by way of copyright. Now, you have seen interface of Flipkart, which is an Indian company. You have seen interface of Swiggy, Zomato. Now, if these softwares are not patented, then they are copyrighted. And once you copyright, you get all the legal rights. In fact, I would say you will get, it is more advantages than patent. Why it is more advantages? Can somebody tell me? Not since we have discussed patents, what is the biggest advantage of having it copyrighted and not as a patent? Okay, I'll give this one. The reason is patent is valid only for 20 years. After that, your invention is going to come in the market. But copyright, it is valid till the lifetime of the original creator and 50 years after the death of the original creator. Which means that the term is of a longer period. Patent is only for 20 years. After that, it has to go into the public domain. But copyright will not go into the public domain. So that is the biggest advantage copyright has over patent. So we are not, in fact, we are not losing over it if softwares are not patented in India. Because if you get it copyrighted, you have a better right. And the other right is, it has criminal liability also. Say if somebody copies your copyright, he's in a chori kar liya. So aapke paas criminal liability bhi hai under the Copyright Act. But under the Patent Act, you don't have that. Under patent, you get only civil rights. Under civil rights means that, you know, you can do only, you can only take civil action. You cannot take criminal action. So if that is the reason why when, you know, sometimes comes to us with an intellectual property, we identify what intellectual property they have. And then we suggest you get copyright also. One is for the term, you get better rights. And the second is for the criminal right. I think I have shared, one more thing about copyright. Copyright, unlike trademark and patent, is not geographical, which means that once you've registered it in India, it is automatically gets registered in other countries also who have signed a treaty. Okay, and this organization comes to be around 120 countries, which is a good number. So this is the advantage of copyright over any other law. Now, we were talking about trade dress, which comes under trademark. Now, the trade dress can also be copyright. It will give double advantage to the organizations. You are able to protect it so that the consumer will never get confused. So, if Ruabza has copyrighted their trade dress, no one can copy it. Because, you know, that bottle is so attractive when you see it in the supermarket. From the distance, you know that this is bottle of Ruabza. Now, how somebody will cheat you? They will cheat you by either changing the trade dress or by actually the content inside the bottle is not the same. The quality is not the same. Now, this happens a lot in the case of lubricants. The lubricants are very expensive. So, how do people cheat the consumers? They cheat by changing the content in the bottle. The bottle is almost the same, the trade dress is the same, and therefore the law has given power to police officers that wherever you see that such kind of infringements are happening, where consumers are cheated, the warrant is not required. Police has huge powers. They can enter the premises of such infringers and they can do search and seizure, and then they can take order from the court and they can destroy such materials which is causing harm to consumers. Now, fourth intellectual property that I want to discuss with you is industrial design. So, as the name says, industrial design means the shape of the product. Now, if you look in your house, the bottle of Harpic is very different. How it is different? Because of the design of the bottle. How it is designed. So, you know, looking at a bottle, you know this is Harpic's bottle. So, there are certain products which you will be able to identify from the shape. Like if you look at Apple phone, you know this is Apple phone. This is not Xiaomi. You would know. This is not Vivo. How you're able to differentiate? Because of the shape. How do you know this is Veleno or this is Creta or this is Audi from the shape of the car? So this shape is called industrial design. And this can also be registered and it can be renewed, but only for one term. There are certain limitations of this law, but you have to see what is your business requirement and accordingly you can protect the shape of the product. Another example that I can give you of identifying shapes of product is the pressure cookers that you have at home. Now, one pressure cooker will be very different from the other. So Prestige pressure cooker is very different from United or Hawkins. You can't have the same shape. Or washing machines that you use at home. In fact, there was a case which happened in Bombay High Court where Videocon was in litigation with Whirlpool. So Whirlpool said that Videocon has copied their washing machine design and it is causing confusion to the consumers. Consumers are thinking that this is Whirlpool. Now, why Videocon did it? Videocon was actually stopped. They actually did it. Why were they doing it? The reason was very simple. Videocon is an Indian company and Whirlpool is an American company. So, you know, in minds of the consumer will think American technology is better than Indian. So that's the mindset. So when the design is copied, you will buy this product. That was the whole strategy behind it. But you can't do it. Law is preventing it. So this is about industrial design. And I've heard professors that they were talking about startup, which is in agriculture space. So I'll be very briefly, I'll touch upon plant variety. Ramneet, can I do it? I have time.
Yeah, sure, ma'am. Sure.
So now what is Plant Variety Act? Now say, you know, you have developed a new variety of plant or a seed, which was not known to anybody, or there's an improvement. You can register it with the registering authority in India. And you will get legal protection that this plant variety is developed by you. Now, as there's a startup in agriculture space, if you develop a new variety, like, you know, a few years back, new variety of wheat was developed by Indian scientists, whereby the quantity of wheat improved. It happened in the case of, I think, rice also. At that time, we didn't have Plant Variety Act, but today we have. So you can register it and you can make economic gains out of it. If you are a private company and this is your invention, which means if you have to give to some other organization within India or outside India, you can do it and you can take license fee or the royalty from that organization. So before I end, I would like to share one more case with you because this case I'm sure will stay with you for many long period of time. So this case is about Chetan Bhagat. He had written a book which was adapted in a form of a movie, Three Idiots. You know what happened here? Chetan Bhagat entered into an agreement with a producer and he gave all the rights. At that point of time, he didn't know that Three Idiots is going to make a huge profit. It went on earning so much money. Today also it's making money. But, you know, Chetan Bhagat will not get any money out of it. Why? Because he gave all the rights. So what he should have done, he should have said, I am giving you limited rights. And whenever you make money, this percentage will come to me. So, you know, after writing this book and after he did making such a massive hit, he could have easily retired. He could have lived a good retired life. But he has not done it because he didn't have good legal advice. So the lesson is, I'm not propagating anything here, but I think the lesson is, especially for startups, make a good team, good legal team, good partnerships, which can help you grow in your business. Shweta is there. She will have her slides up always.
Good to see Shweta. I think the
Thank you, Geeta ji, for your very insightful knowledge on patenting, IPR also. And I'm watching that the participant, particularly the student community, they are watching it very eagerly. And on the same way, I expect good queries, good questions from them also. So now I will request Dr. Shweta Sen for her presentation on role of IP in innovation management, challenges and prospects. So I will introduce Dr. Shweta Sen. Dr. Shweta is an Indian patent agent with elaborate experience in patent and trademark filing system, strategies and patent laws. She possesses a doctorate degree in biotechnology and postgraduate diploma in intellectual property laws. Currently, she is working at Head IPR with Integrum IP Mohali. So I will request Dr. Shweta to proceed further.
Thank you, Dr. Sharma. Thank you. Today I'll be discussing about innovation management. Geeta ma'am has explained in a very nice manner about inventions, how they can be protected, about the types of intellectual properties we can generate. Now we will be moving to one step ahead. That is, what is innovation? You know what is invention? Now, taking invention to the market, commercializing your invention is innovation. You can patent, you can take trademark of anything. Every patent is not marketable. It is not. It may not generate a revenue, but any invention which can generate revenue is innovation. As we can see, the wheel as such was an invention, but when it was used in cycles or vehicles, it became innovation. It started generating revenue, so it became it is an innovation now. Now, very simple question: why innovate? Yes, the startups or companies require innovation for the growth, for standing out, for meeting the needs of the customers. Yes, this is right. But I would like to explain, I would like to cite one example. And this example is about the Thomas Alva Edison. Everybody, I think almost every one of us knows Edison. He was the one who invented electric bulb. He had more than 1,000 patents to his credit. And he had numerous and hundreds of inventions to his credit. Most popularly, as we know, is electric bulb. Some of few I have listed here, that is cinema, film, electric chair, and there are more to his credit. But what Thomas found that despite inventing such a good invention, that was electric bulb, he was not able to sell the patent of bulb at that time. So what his company, that is Edison Corporation, did, they developed infrastructure for electricity generation, for distribution, and also for designing lamps, switches and wiring, so that the electric bulb, the invention of the electric bulb, finds some value in the market. Or hume lagega ki shayad usko bada loss ho gaya. No, his company, which is General Electric, we know GE ke naam se hum sab jante hain. Total worth of GE and this Edison Corporation was more than $20 billion. That too in 1920. $20 billion in 1920, because he made his invention marketable. He sold. He commercialized his invention, electric bulb, by making a roadmap and giving people electricity and everything so that they can buy his electric bulb. So innovation is not simply coming up with new ideas, but it is the process of growing them into some practical use, as he did. Now, what type of innovations are there? Product, process, and service. Product, you are making a new product, like Edison did. He invented a new bulb.
Jin aage USB multiplex laga le.
Or improving an existing product, like there was a bulb with the light yellow light, then with this white and different shapes. And so this is the continuous improvement in the shape and efficiency of the bulb. So this is the innovation in the product, that is bulb. Process is, as we know, that process is something which is used, which is a technology or something which the end product of which is a product. But the if you make a process faster, if it is it becomes economic, it is comparatively cheaper, or it has more efficiency, it uses less energy, then the product will be made very fast, or maybe the cost of the product is reduced. So there can be the innovation in the process. Service innovation, like we are providing a service, say delivering food to the house. The restaurants are serving, but like Zomato and Swiggy are servicing the food to the, like, this is also what they have done. They have developed a software, they have got their patent, they have got the copyright of their software, they have their trademark.
Ramneet, I think there is some disturbance at the part of Dr. Shweta. There is some network issue.
Yeah, maybe.
Yeah, that's what, in fact. That's what, very right. Dr. Shama, there is some interruption at Dr. Shweta's end.
Yeah, there is some network issue because this her pick is also staggered. No?
Statural, yeah. It is very low, yeah.
I think ye light ka issue lagta mujhe kyunki she left.
Yeah, I think she will log in again. Till that time, you can put your questions in chat. You know, we can answer during interaction.
Yes.
Ma'am Geeta, are you there? Ma'am Geeta?
Yes, sir, I'm there.
If you privilege, if you allow, can I ask one question, Dr. Sharma?
Please.
Ma'am Geeta, my question is, like, you were talking about copyrights, and in fact you have copyright for the death of the one who copyrights that. If suppose I have written a book and somebody copies some text from the book and he doesn't acknowledges onto the acknowledgement part, then what would be the role, or what would be, can he be sued into the legal obligations?
Absolutely, sir. Because thing is, even if you take the word use is substantial. Now, thing is, if you picked up even a line from somebody and in the footnote you have not given the credit, which means that you have infringed the right of the creator. So on this basis, you can stop the other party. Now the thing is, how will you stop? So the first thing that we do is, you know, we send notice to the other party. We say that this is what you are doing. If this is unintentional, please stop it. And you apologize, you give an undertaking, you will not do that. Or if you really want to take the legal route, you can take that person to court and you can claim damages on that, if that person has made profit out of it. So the thing is, you know, they have taken in your line to create something new. But, you know, that is not their creativity. So you can adapt. It, you can take code from here, there, you can compile it, but you have to give credit. Shweta has come back. Shweta is there.
Yeah, Shweta, yeah.
I lost my internet connection, some problem in the internet. So I'll be starting my presentation. Yes, sure, I don't know where I lost the connection.
You were somewhere, madam, that you were talking about service, that a service. And okay, they have made a software, and henceforth they can.
Okay, thank you. Okay. I'll be
the
starting.
The slide was of product services.
Yeah.
Okay. Thank you.
This means we are attentive.
Yes. Yeah. So next will be, what are the phases of innovation? So innovation is broadly has two phases: design phase and implementation phase. And this is more elaborative version of innovative process. Basically, design and implementation is one is the two phases. Design is in like brainstorming sessions. Creative people and management people come together and think that what we have, what the problem, what type of problem is there, how to counter this problem, what innovative skills or what type of invention or what we need to do. Then the creative team design or refine the potential solutions. Then experiments are done. If required, more experiments are done. And then action plan is charted out that what type of, how we'll overcome this type of problem. And then implementation of that action plan that, okay, this is what we have to do to overcome this problem or to bring this our company to the next level. So explore, try and do it. That is implemented and then take your idea to the market. Now all this has been done, that this is innovation, these are the phases. Why this innovation management is important? We have heard all about this GE, Edison, and these are some Indian companies like Flipkart, Snapdeal, Paytm, Zomato, Swiggy, Byju's, Oyo, Big Basket. What makes them stand out? They have great products, yes, great people, sure, great leaders, usually. But one more thing, more fundamental thing in their success is innovation management. How they have inventions, they are managing their inventions, they are managing the intellectual property properly. Normally what happens, most of the organizations in India are patenting, are going for the patents, and some of the universities, organizations have more than 400 or 500 patents to their credit. But now the problem is they have filed the patent. They don't know what to do with their patents, their inventions, because they don't have their innovation management committee at place, or they are not managing their innovation properly. They have to scrutinize what type of patents can be commercialized, what can be done. Either maybe some patents are have some commercial value, maybe some don't. So they have to, they must, every organization have innovation management strategy at place. Now, basically there are two things. One is design and other one is implementation. If we want to move more deeper, then these are the steps. Make time to get smart on your intellectual property. Identify IP assets. Link IP strategy to business objectives. Assess vulnerability and maintain clarity of ownership rights. I'll be discussing it very, very quickly. Make time to get smart on your IP. Explore the company's business model, technology strategy and objectives, and provide IP awareness training to the management and the employees. So the IP-driven companies have will have business strategy, marketing strategy, intellectual property strategy, and inventors. All these will be overlapping. Then identify IP assets. Geeta ma'am has explained them very nicely. I'll be touching them very quickly. Identify what type of intellectual property assets you have, whether you have patents, copyrights, trademarks, and designs. If you have patents or designs, you have to get them protected. You have to get them registered, applied for before moving to the market, while copyright and trademark can be taken care of after you go to the public domain. But patents and designs should be novel. So they patents and design you have to file before moving to the market. So identify what type of intellectual property assets you have and what type of intellectual property assets you want to protect first. Then link your IP strategy. Okay, I have this IP strategy, and what will be my intellectual property strategy? Whether it will be defensive, offensive, or just I'll be securing the intellectual property so that somebody can come and buy the intellectual property from me in the form of I can either license it or franchise it. Then what is defensive strategy? As it is it's a key, what is the defensive strategy? We normally say it's a shield type of strategy. Like it keeps a concept safe and prevents others from getting a patent on the same idea and which you of say of your same to your idea and enforce these rights in case of infringement. Offensive is like it builds barriers to block protectors from gaining entry to your proprietary technology. So you have to think of what type of IP strategies to do, and these are all are come under the design phase. And I assess vulnerability. This is very important, as the ma'am was telling, that you have to get your trademarks or patents search properly before filing any patent or trademark, because maybe you are very active that somebody should not copy or infringe your patent or trademark, but maybe you are infringing somebody's mark. So you come into the legal you will be dragged to the court, and you will be in the legal battle with somebody knowingly or unknowingly. So it's better to operate to do the freedom to operate search in the patents before either the novelty search or freedom to operate search, or what type of search is required in your case, and then anticipate risk and potential enforcement issues that somebody is infringing it. Then you have to enforce your rights, and you should be careful that you should not infringe somebody's intellectual property. Then this comes into the implementation when you go to the market, and then you should be clear that you have to maintain your ownership rights. They can be like any intellectual property which has been created before incorporation of the company should be transferred to the company by a proper written agreement with every clause, every condition written very, very clearly. All employees should sign confidentiality and invention assignment agreements. All consultants and dependent contractors should sign agreements clearly stating their obligation to assign intellectual property they develop for the company. Then any business partners or founders or joint development efforts should be clearly articulated in the form of ownership rights of the business partners. And there must be some non-disclosure agreements also be signed if you're disclosing your invention to somebody. So there must be proper written agreements in place. And with this, I stop my presentation here. And with this quote that innovation is a state of mind, this is how you one can...
Thank you, Dr. Shweta. I think, Ramit, there is again some issue with the internet connectivity or to Dr. Shweta.
So now we can open house for discussion.
Yes, yes.
For queries, so participants, they can show a raise of hand.
Yes.
So we
can unmute
one by one.
Or they can also write in the chat box. So I will be reading the queries of the participants and will be putting up with the experts. So yeah, all participants are requested either to raise hand or write in the chat box if you have any query from our two experts. Yes, Sushant.
Yes. Thank you for giving such chance. I just want to ask from the Dr. Shweta ma'am that he was spoken about the innovation, that which part of this tree is very important inside of the innovation. The employees' engagement is very important in innovation. The planning for the innovation is very important, or the strategy for the innovation is very important so that the organizations can be very innovative and very creative. Which one is very important?
Dr. Shweta, can you hear? Dr. Shweta?
I think there is continuously some issue with Dr. Shweta's connectivity. So I will request
Madam Geeta.
Ma'am Geeta to answer on this query.
I would have loved to, but this is not my domain. The question was regarding innovation.
Dr. Shweta has come.
Yeah, Dr. Shweta is here. Yeah.
I'm very sorry. There's some problem with
the internet. No issue.
So I don't know where was the presentation complete?
Yeah, it was product management completed, ma'am. Now we have opened the question hour session.
Okay.
So I will request Abdullah Ashangi to kindly repeat your question from Dr. Shweta. Abdullah.
Thank you, Dr. Shweta, ma'am. It was a very good session. I just want to ask, ma'am, that you were speaking about the innovations. These three of them, which I am just giving their names, which is very important according to you instead of the innovations and creativity of the company. The employees' engagement of the company is very important for innovations. The planning, the innovation planning of the company is very important for creativity of the company, or the strategic planning of the company is very important for more creativity and for more innovations of the company. According to you, which of them should be get as the main and as a central part instead of innovations of the company? Thank you.
I think there is again connectivity issue. Mm-hmm. Tatam, can you hear us?
Yeah, I can hear. So I think, Abdullah, from my experience, what I can tell you is all three are important at different stages of your business. I mean, I am, there's a disclaimer, I'm not an expert in this field, not in this field of innovation, strategizing. I am a practitioner. So, but what we have seen from my experience is usually the legal dispute comes when any of these things is missing. So I think everything is important, but maybe at a different stage of it.
Very right.
Okay. So any other query from any of the participants? I think Sushant Goyal has raised his hand. So yes, Sushant. Good afternoon. Please raise your query.
Yes, my query is that I am looking for the startup for this competitions, and I want to know about the patent rights, copyrights, and other things, because the startup I am going to start, it is based on the plastic, whereas this type of innovation and research papers are there in international level, but in India it will be going to be first one. Before this it was on like it was starch based, but now I am trying to do on feather based, whereas there are various research papers where they have did this type of things, but nowhere in India we have seen this type of project. So I want to start that project at a large scale, at a manufacturing scale. But I don't know that it can be implemented in India or not, because I can see in the research paper there is a C mark, like copyright mark in the paper. So ma'am, can you help me in that?
So Shushan, that different one. Research paper is different. Somebody has done the research, they have taken the copyright on that. Even if they have not registered their copyright, if this person proves that this person was the first creator of this research paper, the copyright exists. Okay, because copyright is, filing is not compulsory. That's one thing. Now your question was that you want to start manufacturing a product which you feel is already registered in some other part of the world. Okay, no problem. Now, let me share the process with you. When you file for patent, that is why we were emphasizing search karo. After filing karoge, to jo patent office database check karega, wo world over ka check karega. Theek hai, wo mana kar denge aapko, because they will say that this patent is already registered in this particular country, maybe not in India. So aapko patent nahi milega. But then if you say no, I have an inventive step. As you were saying, you go starch based up, yours is different. So you will get patent for this part. ओनली फॉर दिस पार्ट, उसका आप ले सकते हैं, नॉट फॉर द एंटायर प्रोसेस, नॉट फॉर द एंटायर प्रोडक्ट. This is second thing. The third thing is, you can't take patent, you can't take copyright because someone else has already taken. But nobody is stopping you from manufacturing. You start manufacturing, you start selling it in India. You take the trademark. ठीक है. Why? Because you know that person has not registered in India. और उनका manufacturing India में नहीं है. Were they manufacturing in India? Then you were in deep trouble.
So ma'am, can you
में आके register नहीं करते?
Yes ma'am, yes ma'am. Please complete.
So जब तक वो register नहीं करते हैं, you are safe, but you will not get the patent.
Okay,
ma'am. You get only for that part where you were saying that you are, it is not a start phase. वो prove अगर आप कर दोगे कि वो आपकी innovation है, you will get patent for that.
Okay, ma'am. Now can you tell me the scope of this startup I am planning in India?
देखो, there's no other option with us but to you know do our own work. हमको startup करना ही पड़ेगा and you know this is the right time. India is young, you know this is the right time that we bring in innovations, we do our, we have a lot of startups and economically will grow with it. So I think there is a lot of scope. You just have to jump. The PhD is taking so much of interest. And when I started, I gave you an example how Dr. Sharma, the institute, IIT Roorkee, they collaborated with Cheema Boilers. Invention unka tha, but they don't have that, you know, scale to manufacture it, which Cheema Boilers already has. So that, you know, synergy is required. Aap khud nahi kar sakte, you find a partner.
And ma'am, my next question is that that copyright is in German. So, see, do I have a problem of paying any copyright expenses or something like that? If wonderful, I start.
Wonderful question you have asked me, Shushan. Thing is, you said in German, which means ki language bhi German hogi.
Yes, ma'am.
Right? Yes, now, ma'am. Thing is, agar wo English mein nahi hai, English mein agar aap isko translate karte ho, then you will get the copyright for that translation.
Okay.
Only for that translation, because the language is different. Okay. So copyright mil jayega.
And ma'am, there is another thing. Can I share screen if I want to show something about the research paper?
Prashant, we will take up individually with madam.
Prashant, this is not the right platform. Yeah, and if I may be allowed to answer your query, okay, this is a very preconceived question or concept you are having. जो आप रिसर्च यहाँ करना चाहते हैं उसके ऊपर आपने अभी कोई रिसर्च किया नहीं है, कोई पेपर प्रेजेंट नहीं किया है. यू आर टेकिंग कॉग्निजेंस ऑफ द फॉरेन पेपर्स. सो आई थिंक इट विल बी अ वेरी प्री मेच्योर क्वेश्चन. फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल यू इम्प्लीमेंट योर स्ट्रेटेजी, राइट? यू स्टार्ट योर कंसेप्ट. पहले ये तो पता चले कि वो कंसेप्ट यहाँ चलने लायक है कि नहीं चलने लायक है. उसकी पेटेंटिंग, उसका TM और उसकी जो IPR है वो तो बाद में आएगी. So I think this is very premature question. So first of all, you concentrate your research, your startup from the Indian perspective point of view. And if you say that abhi tak India mein kisi ke paas koi nahi hai, then you will be having a question that you will be the alone in that. No? So you concentrate on your study, this research first, then come to the patent expert. So any other query from any of the participants? Kindly raise your hand because I am watching that there is no question in the chat. So if there is no chat, no query and no person is interested. Tushar Gupta, no, it was my name. So any
student please ask question. Sushant, wait down. Let other students get a chance. If we don't get, then we'll get back to you. I'll request all students to kindly raise hand as Dr. Sharma is telling so that you can put forward to the question to the panelists and henceforth you get an answer. I believe everyone can hear me.
Yes, sir, we can hear you.
One thing, Mr. Abdullah's question was answered because I lost the internet. Yes.
Okay.
I think Shweta, you can add because, you know, I just gave him from my experience, though this is not my domain, I said each is relevant according to the business stage. So
Ma'am, I could not listen to his question properly. So, Mr. Abdullah, would you please repeat the question?
That was, Dr. Shweta, it was more of conceptual, and I believe Geeta ma'am gave it very right.
Okay. Okay. Yes, I'm sure. Yes.
So, there are now there are two, three questions now in the chat box. So, Professor Deva, kindly you raise first your hand, then I will read out.
Sure, sir. Please. I'm asking what is the basic amount or the minimum amount which is required when you file your patent or copyright or a design, or the costs are different for patent, copyright and design?
Yes, government fees is different for patents. Even government fees is different for organization and individual and startup. For trademarks, it is different for organizations and individuals. For copyright, it is same for organization and different. And for this industrial design, it is also different for individual startups and larger organizations. Yes.
Thank you.
If I may be allowed take up the questions from the chat box. So the first question is from this is from Arijit Pal Singh Gill from MBA PCT. So good afternoon. Where does India stand in number of patents with regards to other development countries like USA, European countries?
India is in first 50 of
world ranking
in IPR index. IP index.
Okay.
Yes.
So, Jitpal, this is the query of your question. Then again, the second question from him is also, we can register our patent through PCT in other countries. Can we take legal action in case of infringement through PCT too in other countries?
No, it is a rather good question, but framed in, I think,
in a wrong way.
Little wrongly. Yes. Wrong. Yes. Yeah. Geeta ma'am, would you like
to
take?
May I add, ma'am? There is this platform, is there, Patent Cooperation Treaty, which helps you to take patents in multiple countries, right? So since we can have the registration, I was asking that, you know, if we can go for some legal action in case infringement is there in some other countries, since PCT facilitates the registration, is there any help for violation of our intellectual property rights as well?
No, thing is, PCT is only for registration of patent. So for infringement, you will have to file civil suits in the country.
Right, ma'am. There was another one. We were discussing about the benefits of patents and copyrights. And so when the patent term expires, you know, the 20-year period is gone. Isn't it now available in public domain and anybody can manufacture? So a copyright registration won't help, actually. You know, we can't stop anybody, the others, because monopoly is lost. Anybody can produce now.
The thing is, both different IPs having different rights. Patent is in the process, the way you manufacture it, and in the product. Say, for example, cold shield, ab usko kaise banate hai, and the vaccine. But copyright would be in other things. That how this process, how did they reach to this process? If that is documented, that is copyright.
Copyright,
so
would be there.
And after 20 years.
Copyright would be there only if you have a patent. Then only we can grant the copyright to someone else.
Now I'll give you example of Pfizer. You know why Pfizer is not giving compulsory license? They are saying that the technology of developing it is so complex. Even if we give compulsory licensing, aap nahi bana pao. Wo kyun keh rahe hain? Process to patent ho gaya, dawai banane ka. Lekin jo steps hai, जो मैंने उसको डॉक्यूमेंट किया है, दैट इज कॉपीराइट. वो एक्सप्रेशन है. अनलेस आई गिव यू माय कॉपीराइट, हाउ यू डेवलप, प्रोसेस बता दिया आपको, बट दैट रिसर्च इज नॉट विद यू.
इजंट इट द वे यू नो,
दैट रिसर्च विल नेवर कम इनटू पब्लिक डोमेन. ओनली द प्रोसेस ऑफ मेकिंग द मेडिसिन एंड द प्रोडक्ट विल कम इन पब्लिक डोमेन आफ्टर 20 इयर्स.
No, I meant was that, you know, if you want to grant somebody the right to copy, as we are having the franchising models of, you know, McDonald's and KFC and all that, you know, you need to be the owner. You should have the patent first, then only you can grant someone else the copyright.
Absolutely. Otherwise, how will you give? See, it's just like a property, sir. Intellectual property, I'm saying that because you have created. Jo aapka ghar hai, jab tak aap usko transfer nahi karte, ownership aapke paas hi rahega. Same is the case with intellectual property. Unless you transfer it, as Shweta gave example of different agreements, unless you transfer it, then you cannot transfer unless you are the owner of it.
All right, thank you, ma'am. One last thing. Is it compulsory to file the patent application through agents only, or can we file on our own as well?
You can do it on your own. You don't need.
Right. Thank you, ma'am.
So there is another question. Geeta ma'am said trademark cannot be copied, but we see variety of things in market which is copied, like Adidas to Adibas or Gucci to Gucci. Why is it so? Why law is not making any control on such things? This is a policia question.
The thing is, you know, this is a widespread problem that we are unable to implement things. I mean, you would see copyright violation, bahut acha digital content aata hai, and then it spreads. You see, you go to any market, you would see DVDs and CDs being sold. So these are all copyright violations. Now, who will do it? Who will stop it? Police has the power to stop it. They are not doing it. And you can also, as a citizen, report it. You can report it that, you know, this infringement is happening. And, you know, today we have social media. See how viral it goes. This person is infringing on the, then the original trademark owner or the copyright owner, you know, will come to know. They are not doing it because they don't come to know. Now, here I'll give you another example. You know, when Microsoft came to India, they were not after you. You were using their infringed copyrights. When I say infringed copyrights, aap unka जो सॉफ्टवेयर यूज कर रहे थे वो समबडी वुड कम दे देते कि हाँ मैं आपका डाउनलोड कर देता ठीक है क्योंकि वो बहुत सस्ता था ओरिजिनल वाज वेरी एक्सपेंसिव माइक्रोसॉफ्ट डिड नॉट डू एनीथिंग दे अलाउड यू टू डू इट इट वाज अ बिजनेस स्ट्रेटजी दे वर मेकिंग यू यूज टू देयर प्रोडक्ट वंस यू गॉट यूज टू देयर प्रोडक्ट दे वर आफ्टर यू नाउ व्हाट हैपेंस यू नो देयर वाज अ टाइम वी वर गेटिंग कॉल्स फ्रॉम आवर क्लाइंट्स Microsoft is there, their legal team is there outside of factory premises with an order from Delhi High Court or Bombay High Court. Humne infringement kiya hai. The only thing I would ask my client is, what is the real situation? Aur hota kya tha ki computers ke andar licensed product har computer mein nahi hota tha. So now we have stopped because Microsoft has become very strict and we have also become aware now. And the cost of the product has also come down. So now we are buying original products. You are a new generation. Our students are like, when we are students, so we know that pirated chalta tha. But Microsoft allowed to do it because they wanted us to get used to it.
Thank That's you,
the story behind
ये,
it.
ये, yeah. So this question was came to me from Ramneet ma'am. मुझे लगता किसी ने पूछा था मुझे उसका नाम तो नहीं याद है. But on the lighter note or on the other side, I will ask ये कि इसका मतलब ये है कि बिल्ली के गले में घंटी बांधेगा कौन, right? जैसे मैम जैसे मैम गीता ने बताया कि आजकल तो सोशल मीडिया इतना प्रोएक्टिव आप अपने सिटी में ही अगर आपको कोई ऐसी डुप्लीकेसी नजर आती है तो आप उसको डायरेक्टली जो है उस कंपनी की वेबसाइट पे जाके दे सकते हैं बिकॉज कंपनीज कैन नॉट मूव सिटी टू सिटी वो तो उनके पास अगर कोई कंप्लेंट आती है तो वो बड़ा क्विक एक्शन करते हैं आई विल गिव यू वन कोट फ्रॉम लास्ट वीक देयर वाज अ टीम From Delhi, ये जो आपके एक बड़ा फेमस ब्रांड है ये इसका माइक्रोटेक का है शायद या कुछ और जो यूपीएस वगैरह बनाते हैं और जो इन्वर्टर्स वगैरह बनाते हैं एंड देर वॉज ए रेट विद जॉइंट ऑपरेशन फ्रॉम द दिल्ली पुलिस एंड पंजाब पुलिस इन रूपनगर एंड उस दुकानदार के पास जो है वो ऑलमोस्ट मोर देन 15 to 16 जो इक्विपमेंट्स थे वो पाए गए एंड वो कंप्लेंट किसी ने भी की हो सो देर इज समवन हु इज रिक्वायर्ड टू कम फॉरवर्ड बिकॉज कंपनी जो है वो उन्होंने अपने लोकल डीलर्स तो बनाए होते हैं लोकल डीलर जो है वो अपना काम करने में अपनी सेल निकालने में विश्वास रखते हैं उनको ये होता है कि मुझे यहाँ बेच रहे ना इस पचड़े में कौन पड़ेगा कौन पुलिस के पास जाएगा कौन कंप्लेंट करेगा उसके बाद कोर्ट कचहरी कौन भुगतेगा But when you are alert on your in your area, you can complain, not complain to the police, you can complain to the concerned company through mail and they will take on their own action. Am I right, ma'am?
Yeah, yeah, definitely.
Absolutely, sir. And there's another thing, you know, how we can stop it. We can stop it if, as a consumer, we are not buying it.
Yes, yes. So I found there is no other query from any of the participants. So we'll extend my thanks to our both experts. And now I will request and invite Professor Satyajit Singh Thin, Professor International Business, PCT Group of Institutes, for extending his vote of thanks. Professor Thin.
Good afternoon, everybody. Well, you know, they say that talk is cheap and advice is priceless. And usually what happens is we find that entrepreneurs are so confident of themselves and their products that they do not look beyond their product. They're so obsessed with the idea. And then they fail to sort of look for advice, look for different sorts of information which they get. And Chetan Bhagat's example by advocate Geeta
Gulati is a perfect example.
When the movie was launched, there was a lot of cry. And then ultimately, they said, okay, we will put your name in the credits. So that's all what he got. A name in the credits at the end of the movie. Nothing else. And probably 10 lakhs for buying the rights of that book on which this Three Idiots was based. Right? This is something which is a very interesting topic. It is also something which is very, very important. And I think we must thank PhD. We must thank Dr. Sharma. We must also thank the initiative of my colleague, Professor Sachdev, that we are sensitizing the next generation about these things at the very beginning. You know, they're not trying to find out about these things when the businesses have started and then it is too late to file for a patent or a copyright and a trademark and so on and so forth. That is, I think, the best learning which we get from these kind of talks. Of course, when Dr. Geeta Gulati, Advocate Geeta Gulati and Dr. Shweta, when they're given their inputs and their experience and they tell us how important and how companies have either lost or made money because of this small advice taken correctly, it is a great learning for everybody. I take this opportunity on behalf of PCT to thank Dr. Sharma, who's helped us in many ways, and also being part of this series where we keep pushing the entrepreneurial idea in the students, and PhD for giving us a platform. Mr. Amneet, thank you so much for the assistance in getting people in, for putting the whole effort to put the whole show together. And to all the students, we are sorry that, you know, we had a limitation on the number of people who could participate, but I'm sure that we all have gone richer by learning a lot of things. Our greatest thanks, deepest thanks, and I would say such sessions are required and welcome, and we must have them again and again and again, even at the cost of reputation, because they are priceless. The advice of the advocates Geeta Gulati and Dr. Shweta Sen, and with good word from Dr. Sharma, these are all priceless. Thank you so much.
Yeah, thank you once again to everyone. It's a really pleasure to have Advocate Geeta and Dr. Shweta and Dr. Sharma, and I'm Rimneet and PhD Chamber. Hats off, and thank you very much. We extend our heartfelt gratitude and keep looking for such insight and knowledgeable, impeccable lectures ahead also. Thank you very much. Thank you very much.
Thank you, sir. And we look forward to organize another session with more number of participants.
Yeah.
500 capacity.
Yeah.
Thank you.
Thank you, Nirej, sir, for the opportunity. Okay, thank you all.
Thank you.
Bye, Geeta ma'am.
Bye.
Geeta ma'am.
Bye.